Okay, so is the screen visible now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
Fine. Yes, sir. So previous day I gave you two numericals to try. Okay, so this was the first numerical and you successfully solved that. That is very good. Okay, and it is also done here. Okay, one thing is left, that is the RMS calculation. Okay, that is not done here. RMS calculation. Okay, so RMS calculation, you can do it. That is Vs by root 2. Okay. And just one small description of the numerical that you already did. Okay. In this numerical, one resistor of 30 ohm, one inductor of 0.5 Henry are in series with one voltage source, AC voltage source. Okay. And it is said that current 4 ampere is flowing. Okay. So now it's your work to find out this source voltage. Okay. And always draw the phasor diagram. Correct. So here, look. R value is given, L value is given. So you have to convert L into XL value. Correct. So if you convert that XL value, then you have to multiply with omega. That is your XL. Okay. It is called the reactive. What is called? What is the name of this XL?
Reactive impedance.
Exactly. No, that is not a reactive impedance. It is called
reactive inductance.
Reactance. Exactly. Inductive reactance. Okay. If it is told to calculate the XC, that is called capacitive reactance. Okay. So impedance you have to next calculate. What is impedance? That is Z. Okay. And I hope you remember this impedance triangle. Okay. The real line is your R and the imaginary axis represents the XL here. So the hypotenuse will give you the value of Z. Okay. So this diagram, is it right? This diagram, is it right? Tell me, I need one answer, whether it is right or not.
No idea, actually, sir.
Yes?
No idea, sir.
Yes, it is not right. The correct diagram will be, like this. It is not correct diagram. Okay? The correct diagram, this is your XL. Okay, no problem here. The correct diagram, this is your Z. Okay, this is your Z. Now it is correct. Okay, so here you can use the Pythagoras theorem and this one is your XL. So Z value is your root under of R square plus XL square. Correct. And next, we need to multiply with the current and then you will get this value. Okay, there may be some deviation from your calculation because this point value will make the difference. Okay. So you will get maybe 650 volt, maybe 645 volt. No problem there. Okay. If higher decimal you are considering, then you will get some different value. Okay, 643, 642, you may get. No problem there. Okay, who is waiting here? Now, so this is your RMS calculation. Now, you have to do the RMS calculation. So here, this 640 volt, this is your peak value. Okay, so now you have to convert that peak value into RMS. So you have to divide it by root 2. What is the value of root 2? That is 1.414. Okay. So then you will get somewhat 455. Is that right? This value, I suppose you got 455 or 454 like that. Okay. Now, next one is the calculation of phase angle. So here, this is your voltage triangle and this one is your impedance triangle. Okay. This one is your impedance triangle. Okay. This is your R. This is your Z. Okay. This is your XL. Correct. So from here, this is also same because VR will be in real axis and VL will be in imaginary axis. So from here, you can calculate the phi value from the phasor diagram. And it may be told to calculate the power factor of this system. Okay, so what is the power factor value? That is the cos phi. So what is the value of cos phi? Quickly calculate and tell me. What is the value of cos phi? Yes, anyone? Okay, this value is almost 0.2 approx. Okay, as per my calculation, this value is almost 0.2 or 0.19. Right. So this value is 0.19 approx. Correct. Now, this one is the next numerical that was given. So this is the internal resistance is 10. Capacitance value is also given, 100 microfarad. Okay. And it is connected to the supply voltage, Vt equals to 100 sine 314T. Okay, so what is the normal frequency here? You can easily say that frequency is 50 hertz, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now from there, what value you need to calculate? The current flow. Okay, and also construct the voltage triangle. So here C is given. So you have to convert this capacitance value into the capacitive reactance, XC. What is the value of XC? 1 by omega C. Omega value is already known to you. So XC value, I hope you got. Okay, and maximum of you corrected this numerical also. Yes, any problem? Any query? Okay, so next we calculate the value of Z. Okay, that is also R square plus XC square. Why? Because this is your R. Okay, and this one is your XC because XC always is in minus Y axis. Okay, so from here you will get the value of Z by using the Pythagoras theorem. Okay. So the value you got is 33.4 ohm. Now this diagram is also similar with the voltage diagram. See here, this is your VR, this is your VC, this is your VS. So from here also you can calculate the angle. Okay. But first we need to calculate the current, right? So here, look, the VC, the current flowing through the capacitor, that is that known to you? The VT is already given, that is 100 sine 314T. Okay, so it is written actually wrong. It is VT, okay? This is actually VT divided by Z, correct? So 3 ampere is your peak current value, right? This is your peak value of the current. Okay, now Next, what we need to calculate? The angle. So angle you can calculate from this voltage triangle. Okay, from this voltage triangle by doing the tan inverse of XC by XR or VC by VR, you can get the value of phi. So from here, if told to calculate the value of power factor, you can get the value of cos phi, and this is your power factor. Okay. Now, from here, the VR, VC, and VS value you will get very easily. Correct. So, this is the basic concept of the RL, RC circuit numericals. That's how you have to do. Okay. And this one, you need to find out this angle value, whether it is leading or lagging. Okay. You have to find that. Correct. So, some of you did find, some of you didn't. So do not mistake this angle part. Okay, this one is important. Don't miss this. Clear? Now, series circuit analysis already done. So we will jump to the numerical directly based on the RLC series circuit. Okay, so this is the simple numerical based on RLC. As you can see, the resistance value is 12 ohm. Inductance value is also given. C value is also given. Okay. So what is in your mind? First, you have to convert this into XL. You have to convert this into XC. Okay. So what is the value of omega now? You have to find out the value of frequency is 50, correct? So what will be the value of omega? That is 314. Okay, so put the value of 314 and calculate the value of XL and XC. Okay, so this one is till now easy. Next, we are going to calculate the circuit impedance. But before calculation, try to draw the phasor diagram, or you can say the impedance triangle. Correct. You have to draw the impedance triangle because R value is known to you. X, C and X, L, these two values are known to you. Correct. So I am drawing this one. Check whether it is understandable or not. So this is your R. Okay. What is the value of your XL that you already got? 47.13. Okay. So this one is your 47.13 XL. Okay. What is the value of XC you are getting here? That is 31 point. It is little bit less. This value is XC. Okay. Now, this value, XL and XC, which one is greater? XL is obviously greater. Okay. So, is the circuit inductive in nature or capacitive in nature?
Inductive in nature.
Inductive.
Exactly. Inductive in nature. So, now, quickly tell me, which one will be leading, the source voltage or the current?
Voltage.
Voltage will be leading. Very good. So now our work is to find out that angle by how much the voltage is leading or current is lagging. Okay. Now, this XL is greater than XC. Okay. Now here I need to find out the Z value. So from here, find out the Z value quickly. What is your net impedance? This is your R, and this is suppose your XL minus XC, because XC will be subtracted from XL because they are in y-axis. So XL minus XC. Okay, now find out the value of Z. Okay, so this is nothing but the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so you are getting this one. Correct. So Z value is 19.4 ohm and voltage is already known to you, 100 volt. So Vs divided by Z is 5.14 ampere. Okay. Now this angle, this current value is known to you. So from this current value, you can calculate the voltage across the resistor, across the inductor, and across the capacitor also. Correct. So now these values you are getting. Okay. So draw the phasor voltage, phasor diagram now. So here you can see this is your I. Okay. Because I is your always reference. Always remember. Correct. This is your VR value. Right. This is your VL value. And this one is your VC value. It will be a little bit less. Okay. That is your VC. Now you have to calculate the net y-axis value. So this is the value of suppose VL minus VC. Okay. So you have to do now the phasor resultant voltage. Okay. So this is your resultant voltage that is already shown here. Okay. Then calculate the angle. 51.8. Correct. So this is your 51.8. Now, can you tell me what is the power factor value? Can you tell me anyone what is the power factor value?
IY VL minus VC.
No, I just want to know the numerical value. That is the angle you already got. That is 51.8. Okay. And what is the power factor value now? Numerical value.
0.619.
Okay. Everyone please check whether 0.619. So you can write this approximately as 0.62. Okay. If you do the round off, then you will get this 0.62. Okay. So here, one thing just notice that you are getting the power factor value as 0.62. Okay. So yesterday I told you that our power factor must be very good. Otherwise, we have to pay for that according to our in our electricity bill. Okay. So this is your 0.62 power factor and our motive is to increase it till the reference value. Suppose that reference value is 0.86. So what we have to do? Do you have any idea what we need to do?
We will increase the phase current.
How will you increase the increment of phase current? Increment of current means the increment of load. Okay. So if you increase the load, your MCB or your fuse will burn. So that is your another problem. Okay. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So that's why to increase this power factor, our first objective will be to reduce this difference. Think very carefully that if you decrease this difference, if you decrease this difference, that means VL minus VC, if this value is decreasing, then your angle will also decrease like this. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if your VL minus VC, see, this one is for your own knowledge. Okay. VL minus VC, if is decreasing, then the angle between the source voltage and current will decrease. Okay, will decrease, and if the angle decreases, then cos phi will increase, isn't it? Because cos 0 is 1, cos 90 value is 0. So cosine of this angle will increase, correct? So the power factor will increase. Okay, so how we can do that? We use that condenser. Okay, you will see that above the fan, okay, one capacitor is connected. Agar kabhi bhi dukaan jao, okay, and you will ask about the condenser, okay, or some capacitor, then that people, that then that man will give you one device. Okay, so we use that condenser. The condenser will increase this power factor. Okay, so that is just for your basic knowledge. Okay,
well, we can use a static capacitor also, no?
Yes, static capacitor is also one type of device. You can use that. Actually, for increasing power factor, we use three kinds of devices. Okay, capacitor bank, right? Second one is that condenser, okay, and synchronous machine. Total three instruments were installed, correct? So if you have fridge, right, so in that fridge also this kind of device is installed, if you look very carefully. Okay, if you ask any electrician that please show me the condenser, where it is, where condenser is connected in fan, then he will show you. Okay, if you have the pump in house at home, then above the pump you will see one instrument, one small device is connected. Okay, one cylindrical device is connected. So that is also condenser. And those instruments are used to increase this power factor. Okay, so I hope the idea is clear. So today you have to try this numerical. Okay, everyone take the snapshot of this numerical. Try this one at home. Okay, and if you solved it in the snapshot,
sir.
Okay, yes
sir. In the earlier numerical, sir, while finding the power factor, sir.
Yes
sir, if we decrease the value of VR, then the power factor will increase.
You have to answer that on your own. See, this is your VL minus VC. Okay, if I decrease the VR, what will happen? See, I am decreasing the VR, na?
Yes,
the, the angle becomes same, constant.
The angle become more. Check here, the angle will become more than the previous. Okay, here the voltage value is, VR value is 62. Okay, you made this 50. Now calculate the power factor. You can get your own answer. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So see, if you have any kind of question, try on your own. If you cannot get answer, you may ask me. No issue. I will say all your questions answers. Right. See, here the question is very good, that if we decrease the value of voltage, the value of resistor, or the voltage across the resistor, will the power factor increase or decrease? Actually, the power factor will decrease. Because see, your voltage value across the resistor is decreasing, but the resultant value, it just goes here. Okay, the resultant value will decrease. This VS value will decrease, but the power factor, this angle will increase. Correct. If the angle increases, then your cosine factor of this angle will also decrease. So your power factor will decrease, not increase.
Yes, sir.
Clear one?
Yes,
okay. Fine. Now everyone, take this snapshot and try this numerical. Okay, if you have taken, then okay, have you taken the snapshot?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So the RLC series circuit is over. Correct. So actually, I don't know whether you know or not, the two modules were already completed. Okay, almost 80% of the module 2 I just completed. Fine, so only one or two portions were remaining. So this one is the RLC parallel circuit. If you know the RLC series circuit calculation, then RLC parallel circuit will become more easier. Okay, now here, look, this is your parallel RLC circuit. Okay, where all the elements are connected in parallel. Right. So here, what is your reference value? Which one?
The voltage.
Voltage.
Very good. So only current will be divided into three parts. One is IR, another one is IL, another one is IC. Correct? So here, look, the voltage across all the elements are same. So we can write VS equals to VR equals to VL equals to VC. Okay? Now, what is the, from this resistor, the value is R. From this inductor, in ohm unit, what is the value? XL. Okay. From the capacitor, what value you are getting? XC. And please remember, they are in imaginary axis. Okay. So, first we are going to draw the phasor diagram. Right. So, here, look, the resistor. Through the resistor, the current flow is IR because V and IR must be in phase always, correct? And if voltage is your reference, in case of inductor, what will happen? The current will lag in case of inductor. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And in case of capacitor, what will happen? This is your V, this is your I. For capacitor, if voltage is here, where will be the current?
So leading 90
degree. Leading 90 degree. Excellent. So this is your leading. Okay. This is your IL. This is your IC. So just combine these two concepts here. Okay. So put the phases of IL and IC. So what is your resultant y-axis current? Suppose IL is greater than IC. IL is greater than IC. Suppose, okay. Then what will happen? See here, the Pythagoras theorem you can apply also. Correct? So from this circuit, this is your, this orange color waveform, this orange color phasor is your resultant current, that is your IS. Okay, now can you tell me what is the relation between the voltage, this is your voltage, and this IS? What is the nature of the circuit? Is it inductive circuit or capacitive circuit? Which one?
Inductive.
Inductive circuit. Excellent. So this is your inductive circuit. Okay. Now, if this is your inductive circuit, so calculate the angle. This is your angle. Okay. And from this angle, you can calculate the power factor. Okay. So, this is the full parallel RLC circuit calculation. Bas, aur kuch nahi hai. That's it here. Okay. Now, we need to calculate the Z value only. That is the impedance value. Okay. So, here, look. This is your IS square from the current, from this here, from the Pythagoras theorem. What you are getting? The IS square equals to IR square plus IL minus IC square. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So from IR, I can write that VR by R equals to IR. Okay. And what is VR? That is nothing but V. Okay. So I can write V by R equals to IR. Okay. Similarly, I can also say V by XL equals to IL and V by XC equals to IC. So just put these values in the equation. Okay, these are all magnitudes. Correct? All these values that we are calculating here, these are nothing but the magnitudes. Okay, these are all magnitudes. So, from here, you can get this IS value as V by Z. So, Z value you can get from here also. Okay, so what is the value of Z now? I am writing on the top because I don't have space here. Okay, so Z value is 1 by R square plus 1 by XL minus 1 by XC whole square. Okay, then in root, then the inverse of the whole value. Is this clear? This one? Is the calculation clear to everyone? Check the calculation of Z. This is the magnitude you are getting. Okay, this is the magnitude of the Z you are getting here. Okay, so
sir,
yes,
why there is minus one in the power?
That is called inverse. Okay, see here, V by Z is present here, this point, V by Z is present here. So when you need to calculate this Z, so inverse sign will appear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, because you are getting what? Suppose I am writing 1 by A equals to 3. Okay. So what I can write? A equals to 3 inverse. I can write. Okay. So using this concept, I am getting this Z value and inverse is appearing. Clear one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, this current calculation and the impedance calculation in parallel RLC circuit is now done. Right? Next, this one is not needed right now. Okay? See, the Z calculation is also done here. Okay. Now, this Z inverse, this 1 by Z, there is one terminology. We called this one as admittance. Okay. This is called admittance, that is denoted by Y. Okay. Inverse of Z is called the admittance of the circuit. That is called the 1 by Z. That is the symbol is Y. Okay. Now, what is actually resistor? The resistance value, what is the function of this resistance? It actually opposes the current, isn't it? So, if you take the inverse of R, then what is the meaning of this? That means this value will help to flow the current, the opposite meaning. Right?
Yes, sir.
So this is called the conductance. I hope that you learned this conductance term in 11-12. Okay. So yes, this is the concept of conductance. What is the resistance? Resistance opposes the current flow. So inverse of resistance will help the current flow. So that's why it is called conductance. Okay. So now today you learned two new terminologies. First one is the conductance. Another one is the admittance. Okay. So no more will be taught today. First, digest up to this part. Okay. Impedance of the parallel RLC circuit. Correct. And the module 2.4 will be uploaded today. Okay. Just right now after the class, I will upload that. Okay. So till now, if you have any query, you may ask and try to solve the numerical that I showed you. Okay. And whatever book you have, whatever book you bought for theoretical purpose and for each type of numerical I will show you. And if you want, you can follow any kind of book. Okay. And any type of numerical you can solve. If you are having any kind of problem during the solving of that numerical, you may ask me. Okay. But try to solve it. Basic numeric, basic electrical is full of numericals. Okay. If you understand the basic concept, try to solve the numericals directly. Okay. So if you have any query, you may ask. And all of you give your attendance in the chat box. Okay. So thank you, everyone. You may leave the meeting. Your class is over.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.